The celebration of freedom continues as ICAR comes to the fore, honoring pillars of the African freedom movement. Reflecting on St. Lucia's emancipation celebration, ICAR's president highlighted the need for Marcus Mosiah Garvey to have been highlighted during this year's celebration. The president underscored the pivotal role which the Jamaican-born activist played in ensuring Caribbean slaves were given freedom.
We tend to look at the entire month as Emancipation Month and taking into consideration also the birthday of the Right Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey, which all forms part of the emancipation celebration because, as we all know, Marcus Garvey came at a time just, you know, after Emancipation Declaration was made. And he gave us the cause to raise our heads and be proud of ourselves as black people. And he really mobilized black people all over the world, you know, not only in Jamaica, but throughout the Caribbean islands, you know, and South America, and even on the mainland, the continent of Africa, you know, and America and so on.
Mr. Alexander highlighted briefly the plight of the black community post-emancipation. He says a lack of representation allowed for the white supremacists to stifle the growth and advancement of the black culture. The ICAR president encourages activists to continue fighting for their rights amidst harsh oppression.
Black people got representation because he saw the plight of black people. Wherever he went, he saw how they were, you know, destitute and living in abstract poverty, and you know, and everything was heaped up against the black people to actually keep them down. So we really need to pay homage and give thanks for the life and the coming of Marcus Garvey, the 157th anniversary of his birth. And this is an activity, or this is something that is celebrated all over the world, you know, where people pay homage and acknowledge the contribution of Marcus Garvey.
The ICAR president highlighted the need for Pan-Africans to seek reparations from their former slave owners. He says emancipation is an ongoing process and the fight for freedom must continue. Mr. Alexander prays that justice will be served for the black community during his lifetime.
Emancipation itself is a process, and we all must play our part to aid that process and ensure we even fight for in this time for reparations, because our ancestors have done their job. They came and they have made the ultimate sacrifice of giving their lives for the cause of emancipation, for the cause of our liberation and freedom and for justice for us as a people. And the baton has now been passed on to us to fight for the next generation, especially on the issue of reparations.
Mr. Alexander provided a calendar of events for the celebration of Marcus Garvey.
For the month of August, we have a couple of activities happening. On the 10th of August, this coming Saturday, we have what is called the Marcus Garvey Market Day, and that will be taking place at the Castries Market. On the 17th of August, we have a Grand Marcus Garvey Rally and March that will be taking place in Canaries, Canawi, as we like to say. And this is an activity where all those activities are pretty much open to the public. And we're inviting people to come and partake in the activity to be more educated about Marcus Garvey.
The celebrations will culminate with a Grand Conscious Reggae Concert taking place at the Vigit Sport Complex on Saturday, August 31st, 2024. For the DBS News World, Manasa Stanislas reporting.